a go red in her home. No brimstone, it a go jet in her home. Hey, the bad a go to bed in her home. Cause if you know that you cold a dead in her home.
This it a go red in her home. Brimstone and fire, it a go jet in her home. Hey, no bad a spread no bed in her home. Cause Babylon is going down.
Greetings and welcome to Jesse I Interviews, recorded and produced on the unceded lands of the Wurundjeri Woi Wurrung people of the Kulin Nation here in Naam, or Melbourne, Australia. This episode is a follow-up to the last one, which featured an interview with Luciano that I conducted in 2002 on my first trip to Jamaica. This episode features Luciano again, but this time he's alongside his longtime friend and touring partner Mikey General. I've had the pleasure of crossing paths with Mikey a few times over the years, and I have to say he's one of the nicest guys in reggae music. He and Luciano obviously have a good relationship that has endured over the years, dating back, I believe, to their days together at Exterminator Records back in the early 90s. On one of their Australian tours, I met them at their hotel room where Mikey was acting as a chef for the touring party, cooking up an Itaal feast for all that were present. Good food, too. This interview is from their first time in Australia, though, back in 2007, when they came into the studios of PBS in Collingwood for a live interview during my radio program, Babylon Burning. It's a really good one, if I do say so myself. An impromptu acoustic version of Redemption Song is a highlight for me still. Let's get right into it. Jesse I interviews Luciano and Mikey General in Melbourne, Australia, back in January 2007. Yes, you're on 106.7 PBS FM. Chant Down Babylon is the name of the show. Jesse I with you for another 45 minutes until 7 p.m. And right now we got something very, very special. It is with my great pleasure that I welcome to the studios here at PBS none other than the original messenger himself, Luciano.
Greetings, Brother Jesse.
Yes, alongside man like Mikey General.
Rastafari.
Every time, man.
All right, well, Luciano, the last time I spoke to you was back in 2002 at Black Scorpio's Yard, and a lot's happened since then. But for the people that missed that interview first time around, I'd like to just start at the beginning. And you can tell the people what life was like for you growing up as a youth in Manchester and the early days, how you got started in the music business.
Well, first, but I just want to say give thanks, you know, because I always wanted to come to Australia and give thanks for this opportunity, you know. Thanks for having us on the radio. I started out from a very humble beginning, you know, tying out goats and feeding rabbits, you know, going about my daily chores while doing all that. I'll be singing, you know. I grew up in the church. My mother and father had 9 of us, 5 girls and 4 boys. I'm the 7th child. My father died when I was 11 years old. So we had to learn to help mommy to cope through the rough times, you know. Well, you know, one of the main thing about the rural kid or youth growing up in the countryside, you don't have much job opportunities, so from time to time we would migrate to the city and so on. I've graduated from high school, and then I didn't have a job really. I couldn't get a good job in Mandeville, so I ended up selling oranges in the marketplace.
Right.
Even during those days, I would still carry along my guitar with me, and I stayed there for about 3 years until I moved to Kingston, where I, you know, mastered the upholstering skills, start doing building settees and all those stuff, and still had in the back of my mind the drive to do music, you know.
Right.
I grew up in the church, as I said, singing choruses and singing on a church choir. And my respect and love for the Bible grew stronger and stronger as, you know, I grew older, you know.
Right. Well, what about the first break in the business, you know? Where's the first time you went into the studio, or did it start first on the sound system?
I started doing dub plates, and I remember I was introduced to Ricky Trooper.
Right.
And I did some dub plates for him at the time. He was clashing with Stone Love. And the night he invited me over to the, it was Prison Oval, the dance, the big dance was. And you know, from a youth growing up in church, it was never normal that a church man could really end up in the dance hall, you know, like that. But you know, I was dressed up in one of my church suit.
Right.
That night. But it was so great that from then on, it's like things just start happening, because I felt good about it. I was in the church always singing and all that, but I just felt in my mind that there was something that I could be singing about, like to help my people, to sing about the system and all that. We can't do that in the gospel church, singing in gospel, I'm telling you. You know, from time to time, I've always tried to find the ways in me I could express myself. And so after the era when Ricky Trooper introduced me to the dance hall, then he carried me to Mr. Earl Hedges from Aquarius Records, where I was introduced to him. This man, he gave me the first rhythm I did, Ebony and Ivory, a cover version from Stevie Wonder and Paul McCartney.
Right.
And from then on, things started happening. I met up with Sky High for Mama Production, and then I moved on to a new name, still shopping around to find a label or a stable, you know, out of which I could work. I did song like Give Love a Try for Mr. Castro Brown from New Name Label. And then I was there for a while until I met up with Freddie McGregor. And then I came up with Shake It Up Tonight album. That was a big album for me, you know. It gave me the first recognition in the UK scene. I went number one for 8 weeks in the UK charts. And so things started happening until later on, about 93. Well, my first record came out in 1992. And about 1993, I was introduced to Fatis by same brother Mikey General here. And from then on, I started doing some big hits like Neighborhood Watch, Poor and Simple, One Way Ticket. Some great hits, you know, Lord Give Me Strength and Who Could It Be, and you know.
Yeah, and you were almost exclusively working with Exterminator from the next few years.
Yes,
from then,
right? Yes, because at that time, Fatis had, you know, we had signed a contract with Fatis. You know, and from then on, I was exclusively singing for Exterminator.
Right.
And we got an album deal with Island Records, and my first debut album was Weirdest Life.
Yep.
And then The Messenger came along, you know?
Yeah. That's something that's very rare for artists in Jamaica. Artists work with all different producers. You got all different 7-inch singles coming out. But for that time, you just worked with Fattis, you know?
Yeah.
Were there a lot of producers sort of queuing up, you know? How was it as an artist in Jamaica to maintain that?
Well, one thing I do know, you see, when you have a producer who's concentrating on you and you feel like you're sufficiently attended to, you don't see the need to really shop around much, I'm telling
right.
you. So at that time, you know, we're talking about Fatis having all those, we always have studio hours at Anchor. We used to work at Slipe Road. Before Anchor was Anchor, it was, you know, Gussie Clark was more like...
Music Works.
Yeah, you got it, man.
Yeah, man.
And all those years, we were there doing our thing, and Fatis would provide it to the time. We had all these rhythms, and Sly would come in, and Robin, and Danny from the Firehouse, and then he had the Firehouse crew working in studio. I had everything for me, and Mr. Dean Fraser was there as my musical arranger. He would get all the backup folk vocals and all that. So things were just happening. I had no need to stray, you know?
Yeah, well, on that note, I reckon we might go to one of these tunes from that time, one of the big hits for you from that first album for Ireland, Where There Is Life. It's Me Again, Jah. This is definitely one of your biggest tunes.
Definitely, man. One of my favorites, too.
What can you tell the people about this one?
When It's Me Again, Jah was done, that was the first time I was started doing, like, growing my locks at that time. I was,
right.
you know, really sighting up some heights,
yep.
and, you know. And it was more like my inner depth. Reaching deeper in myself to know that as a spiritual youth and as, you know, with all these opportunities, I consider myself well blessed. But all my intention was to do positive music and conscious music. So It's Me Again, Jah was to reaffirm to my people out there that I am about culture and about spirituality. And it also reaffirms to me also that from time to time, I have to go back to God on my knee and ask Him to guide me, you know, through these rough times.
Yes, I am.
Glory, hallelujah, hallowed be thy name, O Most High God. Glory be to the Most High God, hallowed be thy name. King of kings and Lord of lords, worthy to be praised. I ascribe to you dominion. You'll always be the same. It's me again, Jah, as I fall on my knees today. Help me, God, I pray. Don't let me get away. It's me again, Jah, as I fall on my knees today. Help me, God, I pray. Preserve my soul today.
will see Pharisees and backbiters taking up in vanity. But I know you control my destiny, and from you all blessings flow. From yesterday, even today, and tomorrow, it's me again, Jah. As I fall on my knees today, help me, God, I pray. No one at me can away. It's me again, Jah. As I fall on my knees today, help me, God, I pray. Preserve my soul today. My heart is willing, my flesh is weak, but still, oh God, I seek to walk your way, your holy way. I pray my soul you'll keep, though my enemies encamp at me. As I fall on my knees today, help me, God, I pray. Don't wanna be carried away. It's me again, Jah. As I fall on my knees today, help me, God, I pray. Preserve my soul today. Ah, glory, hallelujah. Bless my soul, oh Jah, oh Most High God. Say glory be to the Most High God. Alone be thy name, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, worthy to be praised. I'll ascribe to you dominion, power and grace, throughout the years and years to come, and for our race. It's me again, Jah, as I fall on my knees today. Help me, God, I pray, for what I be carried away. It's me again, Jah, as I fall on my knees today. Help me, God, I pray, preserve my soul today. It's me again.
Yes, the sounds of Luciano right here on PBS 106.7. Of course, I'm joined in the studio by Mikey General and Luciano here in town to play tonight at the ESPY, a big, big show. I think this one is just about sold out, but I hear there may be some tickets still at the ESPY. All the other ticket outlets have sold out, so if you're looking for a ticket, maybe go down there right away.
Definitely.
Make sure you keep listening to the show, though, because we were just talking about that tune there. It's Me Again, Jah.
It's Me Again,
and
Jah.
An affirmation of your faith, Rastafari.
Definitely.
One thing I wanted to ask is, in the early days, in the early 90s, when you started in the business, this is a time to generalize when reggae music, slackness, gun lyrics, this sort of thing, the jump-up dancehall beats were dominating. But you have man like Garnet Silk, Tony Rebel, and Luciana that were bringing the cultural music back into the dance. What was it like as an artist in those times coming with a message of Rastafari when it was so different in Jamaica?
You know, incidentally, just before Garnet Silk came up, you know, I had a discussion with a producer. You remember?
Bingy General.
Bingy General. He was producing a lot of hits at that time, and I said to him that I want to do some hits, and he was saying, well, you know, if you now come with some hot things, and someone said, what do you mean by hot things? But the type of hard things and type of dance and slackness and bling bling kind of music. Mm. So we had one long debate in Aquarius Record that day.
Yep.
In that studio, that record shop in the middle of Half a Tree, until rain came down, tumbling rain. And I was saying, yeah, because he was debating that if you're not singing some little bling bling song, we can't reach anywhere. And I was adamant about it that the foundation of life didn't start with slackness.
Mm.
So we have to, you know, I'm telling him that just give us a chance and he will see. And I even went as far as I said to him, say, he might go see me down the road and believe me, my brother. And then that's not in a long time from there, Garnet C came out with Buju Banton and Tony Rebel bust out on the scene. So when I saw Garnet C coming out, I got so much strength from that I just said to myself, you know what, this is my sign, this is my cue. That I should continue, that I should sharpen up myself, write some big hits and get myself prepared for the journey.
Yeah.
So I just knew it. And there's no way in which a generation can live on just frivolousness or slackness, or, you know, it will last for a time, but it can't last forever. Mm. Only salvation lasts forever. That's one thing I know. I'm reassured with that.
Yeah, no, well, yeah. For me, I was always a fan of the 70s reggae, the roots reggae, carrying the Rasta message, and a lot of the 80s reggae sort of seemed to lose its way, and I lost my interest in the music to a degree. But these days in Jamaica, we seem to have both. You've got all our young artists, Mavado coming up, Vibes Cartel, doing the gun tunes, same as ever. But we've also got all these other artists that are coming with a pure cultural...
Mucho,
exactly.
Turbulence.
Mm-hmm. You have Richie Spice,
Fantan Moja, Chuck Fender,
you know, Bushman.
Bushman.
Yep.
We have a rich heritage. You know, we have a whole barrage of righteous people around here.
Richie Spice sing that tune.
Yeah, I know.
Whole barrage of righteous.
So there's really hope, and I do believe, you know, Brother Jesse, that these are the last days, and as the Bible says, these are the days when those who are crooked have to come show up themselves. Mm. Those who are crooked becoming more crooked, and those who are righteous have to be righteous still. So these are the time when we are going to see the harvest of mankind. So nothing going to hide now. For those even pretending, you have some people been under Rastafarian banner and been all these years shouting John and everything, and then you see how them shift and switch and gone over to the pagan side. Mm. So those people, you can tell that they were not genuine from the beginning, you know?
Yeah, I actually wanted to ask, earlier in the show I played a tune, Luciano alongside Sizzler. Mm-hmm. And Sizzler's a man that I've always had enough love for and maximum respect, but he started with tunes like...
Black Woman
and Child, Praise Ye Jah, these sort of songs.
Oh God, Blast, Ima Jah and all those hits.
And now we're getting songs like Pump Up Your Pum Pum,
Big Lang Gun and all them.
So disappointed, man. I think he got frightened by the bling bling and, you know, what's happening in the world out there. And there's some people who don't have the full conviction to know that righteousness will take them to the ultimate. Mm. They believe that they have to be singing all these songs to get the applause. And we're not singing for applause here. Mm. And I think that Caesar, he came in the scene as a young man. I think most of the people who just came in from a young, tender age, they tend to be freak-minded. I find out that about those people. Mm. Well, for me, you know, I've been through the rough times, I've paid my dues, and I came out more like at the age of 29, going 30. Mm. I started to get my good recognition in the music. So I was prepared for all of this. And I tried to be a guide and inspiration for Brother Sizzler, but to some extent, I think he was misguided by some other people. They have bad influence, other, you know. Because even when in the camp, when Jesse Gender came in the crew, remember the exterminator crew?
For real.
That man came with a bag of philosophy behind him. Mm. You know, with a bag of ideology and all them stuff. That too. And I think that messed up Sizzler head, because he used to go up at Sizzler yard. You know, the youth, he is.
Indoctrinated.
Yeah, man. Just is one of the culprits who has infiltrated the young youth mind.
Right.
And then you have some of these young youth like Sizzler now. They're not quick to listen to elders like myself. And then feel like, yes, they have arrived and they want to establish themselves. And them are the moon king and this and that. At that, I take up the man, I'm not king. Just hype.
Yeah. Well, that's what it seemed to me. Like, when you can do a tune like Big Long Gun and get a massive forward, forget about the message.
Man, because, as you know, as Lucian rightly told, you know, Sizzler was one of our prodigies. Lucian is actually the first man to carry Sizzler on the road. Mm. He toured with us for many years, you know.
True,
for
man.
About 5-6 years we've been touring together. Mm. And to really see him come out and do songs like Big Lang Gun. And,
I'm so disappointed.
You know, it really is a shock to us, you know.
Right.
And, you know, after a while, he did a song album for Bobby Digital called The Real Thing.
The Real Thing.
Yeah. And, you know, me and Donovan went up to his house and we saw him and we said, yes, Sizzler, that is the way you must see. And him said, yeah, man, I done with them gun tune. And next thing we know, the man gone back in at the gun thing. I don't know what. You know what I mean? It's not right still, you know, and I just hope that, you know, as he gets older, he sees the follies of his ways and try to change back and come to the roots, you know?
Yeah. Well, Mikey, maybe this is a good point to get back to talking about you guys. Maybe you can start and tell the people a little about your start in the business, which is quite different to Luciano, but also your upbringing, where you were born, what life was like.
Yeah, I was born in England still, you know, but I grew up in Jamaica, you know?
Right.
I live in Jamaica from when I was 2 years old, you know? Well, I used to live in Arborview, and then I moved to Mullins Road, and that's where I really basically grew up, you know. I was part of the church choir and the school choir, You know, basically most Jamaican artists that you see out there, they go through the church and the school.
Mm.
So, you know, and I used to sing in my community, and when the people in the community used to hear me, them say, Mike, you can't sing, you know. You have to take this thing more serious. So, you know, sound systems would be in the area and they would say, Mikey, come and sing on the sound. And that's where I really got that start, you know, them singing on the sound systems, like big sound systems in the 70s. Because I really started singing on sound systems from in the 70s.
Right.
Yeah, that sound like I used to sing on Kilimanjaro. I used to sing on a sound called Virgo, Gemini. Those were like the big sounds in the 70s. And then, you know, 1982, I went back to England to live, and I used to sing on Saxon and Coxon sound system, you know.
Right.
And then I've been there for many years and started recording for Dub Vendor Fashion Music.
So you started your recording career started in the UK?
No, it actually started in Jamaica. Okay. You know, my first recording was done in Jamaica while still attending school. A song called Roots My Roots, you know.
Right.
And for a producer named Roddy Silence down by Maxfield Avenue.
Mm-hmm.
But when I went to England, I decided not to do any kind of work. You know, I was working in a factory, you know, and this guy came to me, this brethren that I know came to me and said, Mikey, you're going to be in this factory for the next 25 years. And when he said that to me, it shook me.
Mm-hmm.
He said, what you say? 25 years? So I just go to the boss and tell him, say, give me all leave, sick leave, every leave.
Yeah, man.
And from that, I just say, look here, if I can't make it in a music, I'm not going to make it none at all. So I just leave all work and start sing and you know.
It took a strength to do that, though, you know.
Yeah, yes, I believe
man.
It.
Yeah, yeah, man. Because it's the same way my boss came to us one day with a booklet.
And pension said, plan.
So we have a pension plan. So we said, pension plan? At that time, I was doing my poster. And I said, hell no. I'm going to get out of here now.
No.
That's when I decided. Leave that thing. I couldn't imagine myself getting old in the industry.
No. Yeah.
You know,
I just knew that there was something in me that had to give birth to.
Mm.
Yeah, man. I agree with you, Lushika. When the man tell me said 25 years, and I look down 25 years and said 25 years in a factory.
Say last year.
No, that could never be for me. So I leave that work and start sing and Saxon, you know. And then when I start singing Saxon, I recorded for Dub Vendor. And I start tour with David Radigan and Maxi Priest, Tipper Irie, all those people I used to tour with and thing. And,
right.
You know, 1992, I decided to say, well, I had enough for England. I couldn't take the weather. I can't take the cold.
Yeah.
And I said, boy, I'm coming back to Jamaica. And, you know, I came back to Jamaica and I hook up with Brother Luciano. And as you know, they say, the rest is history.
Yeah, that's
we've been touring for over 10 years now, over 12 years now, and we've been hitting the road and we've just been delivering the message.
More than that, General.
That's so long.
More 14, about 14 years.
A long time within that.
Long time for real.
Mm.
Well, on that note, I want to play a tune now, Mikey General. This one you did at Exterminator must be about 96, 97, 98, Babylon Cake.
Yeah, oh, big tune.
Yeah, man. All right, you're on PBS, Mikey General and
PBS.
Luciano.
Music is at its best. Rest.
And everybody wants a taste, they would have killed every day comes. Rasta don't want none. Hey, hey, the Babylon bake a cake. And everybody wants a taste, they would have killed every day comes. Rasta don't want none. Hey, I say to vanity, let go of me. Go find somebody else to call a fool. I said to righteousness, come set me free. For I know that in the end you alone shall rule, yeah. So the mythology and them love seeds, yeah. Say Babylon, I hold them with them chicks and cheeks, yeah. Rasta now get caught by no dragon or the beast, eh. Say me a pop my little bungle and I move to the east, eh. It's Babylon bake a cake, and everybody wants a taste. Them would have killed you if they come.
Jamaican. And everybody wants a taste, them would have killed you till they come. Rasta don't want none. Hey, hey. I said to Colonel Moy, please stay behind. I know you wanna take me for a slave. I said to the divine, come pull my soul and teach me the way I should behave, yeah. Some of them are run down luxury life, yeah. And they don't wanna do the things that are right, yeah. So I know they're heading for destruction. And it won't be long, no, it won't be long, no. Cause Babylon bake a cake, and everybody wants a taste, them would have killed you for the cause. Rasta don't want none, hey, hey. Say Babylon bake a cake, and everybody wants a taste, them would have killed you for the cause. Rasta don't want none, Rasta don't want none. None of them tricks and cheats, Rasta don't want none. None of the Babylon. By a true meditation with some nice inspiration, so I can feel the vibration in the hills and where me have me habitation, yeah. Babylon bake a cake, and everybody wants a taste, them would have killed you till they come. Rasta don't want none, hey, hey. It's Babylon bake a cake, and everybody
minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit, but my hand was made strong by the hands of the Almighty. So I followed in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help me sing this song of freedom? That's all I ever had, redemption song, redemption song. Emancipate yourself from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Whoa, have no fear for their nuclear energy, cause none of them can stop your time. Oh, long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and some say it's just a part of it, and we gotta fulfill the book. Would you help me sing this song of freedom? That's all I ever have, redemption song, redemption song, redemption song.
Selassie, I know, live in the studio at PBS here. Mikey General alongside Luciano. That's got to be the best Bob Marley cover I've ever heard in my life. That's one that's got to go out to all those people that are wondering about the show tonight. Mikey General and Luciano, backed by the man Ricky Trooper tonight at the SB in St Kilda. Of course, this one is going to be done sound system style. So it's not a full band, but it's Luciano and Mikey General singing over rhythms played by man like Trooper.
Yeah, yeah.
But obviously, we got the live element same way. So
yeah, man, it's going to be there. Jesse. But, you know, we're hoping that the next time we come, we can come with a band, you know? Yeah. Brother Simon is working on it here. Yeah, next time we come, we want to come with the full band, you know?
Yeah, no respect to the hard work and promoter, Brother Simon, Empress
Carla,
not Anna, you know?
Yeah, man.
Give thanks.
Well, I got to say, we're just happy to have you out here any which way. It doesn't matter if a band or sound system. We're just grateful to have you guys here.
I must say to Brother Lucy that, you know, on behalf of us, all of us who have come, you know, myself, Luciana, Ricky Chupa, and Mr. Copeland Forbes, you know, it's a pleasure to come to Australia.
Great honor, man.
You know, it's been a lifelong dream of mine to come to Australia. Definitely. And when I've come now and see how the music has reached so far, this has given me a lot of strength. You know what I mean? Because sometimes you wonder if you're doing this thing and if it's really going out there. But when I see it reach so far in Australia, it really gives me a lot of strength, you know. Yeah.
And I mean, the response has been great. The turnouts have been great. Oh, my. You know what I mean?
What about at the big day out shows when you're playing to a crowd that's not necessarily a reggae crowd?
I couldn't believe what happened the last performance, right? In Sydney?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Sydney.
The crowd swelled so much that even the security points, they had to move.
They break them down. Wow.
Yeah.
And they had to close down the show for a while. And that's some of the people dispersed, you know.
But you see,
it's happening, man.
What I find out, they say that it's not a reggae crowd. It's really not. It's a really more a rock concert.
Yeah.
But when you start to sing certain songs, the people know them. They know some of Luciana's songs.
You know what I could say about that, that multitude?
Mm.
I don't even want to say crowd. It's a multitude.
Yeah.
It's a music people. These people just love music.
They don't love music.
I believe if you go up there with Kumina or anything, they would just jump to it same way.
Right.
These people love music. Mm. When I see thousands of people just... they're just hanging out, waiting for the stage to get alive, or the Lily World, or the other world. Mm-hmm. But they're just jamming.
Yeah, man. It's been real good, you know.
Because I walk around a little, you know, and I saw some other tents, some guitar, the commander spin, some guitar people just having fun. So they just love music. And I'm very impressed with the people of Australia.
Yes.
And New Zealand too, you know.
Yeah, it was good in New Zealand.
Well, I tell you, tonight you're in for something special, because in Australia they know Melbourne as the reggae capital.
I've got to go and get myself, you know, sorted out.
We heard that from a coming on. We were in Byron Bay.
Yeah.
And you know, a lot of people, the Byron Bay was real good.
Yeah.
You know, but when we were there, the people said, Yeah, you're going to some nice places, but wait till you reach to Melbourne. Yes. Everybody has been telling us about
thanks
Melbourne.
To man like you, though, brother. Hey, Jesse, because you keep the music playing in their ears. Man. Thank you, man. I heard some, while we're on our way here, I heard some songs you played with me. It's been a long while I've ever
even
heard
that
this
Luciano
jacket,
that you just played a little while ago with Mafia, you know,
I'm
and
very
Fluxy.
Impressed. I'm impressed.
Right.
That's very rare.
Ali, Word Power One song. That, oh, man.
Man, well, I tell you, man, if this show went for 6 hours, I could sit here and play nothing but Luciano and Mikey General.
Thanks again, Brother
Jesse. You can see all the sevens here stacked up, but we didn't get through. We only got 12 minutes. Before we go, I got to ask, my brethren Andy Ice wanted to know where the name Luciano came from.
Well, that name was given to me by Mr. Homer Harris, you know, one of my first producers. He's still my chief advisor. You know, I don't make no major move without talking to him. He's
right.
My, you know, musical counselor, and, you know, he's a spiritual guide for me. He, you know, he saw something, probably it could be the range of my voice or something. He associated me with, you know, Luciano Pavarotti. And even those days, you know, I used to wear my felt hat and everything. That, so he must have associated me with, you know, that Luciano, or Lucky Luciano.
Right.
Something was going on there. But when I investigated the name, and as I became more involved in the mission and see the seriousness of the music, I investigated the name and I realized L-U-C-I is a prefix, which means light, and Luciano is bearer of the light. So I said, let's move along with it.
Yeah.
But then I came along with the title, The Messenger.
Yeah.
Because I really love that title. You know, it signifies what I'm about.
Yeah. And with a title like that, you can't ever stray from the roots.
Luciano, the Messenger.
No.
So I just doubled them together. Luciano, the Messenger.
Yeah. What about Stepa John?
Stepa John now was the name I used to use, and most producers, they don't want to hear about the Stepa.
Yeah.
So where you from? Central Village. What's your name? Stepa John. And man said, boy, I hear me. No studio was not going.
No, but I want to know work.
Because a Stepa is like a hot, you know, yeah, like yeah. a gangster, you know?
Yes, I well, I got the tune here somewhere, Hot Stepper, so we're going to have to play this one. But I also wanted to ask, one of the things that I always respected about you, Luciano, is that at the height of your success in the 90s with Exterminator, you just retired from the music business for quite a while, took a break, like a sabbatical, and just chill out. Yeah, tell the people about that.
But I just, that saved my life.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, when you get involved in the music and lots of things happen, you're going on tour, you're leaving your family and loved ones behind. If you're not careful, your life can be shattered. And I think that's what has happened to many of the people, many of the greats of the greats. So they don't get much time to recollect and you know, recharge. And I think every human being is entitled to some time of meditation. And, you know, right now I've reached a state of mastery where I can, you know, get my Sabbath, because I still hold my Sabbaths.
Mm.
And I think that even a Sabbath is good enough to hold a man firm in a spiritual sense, you know, equilibrium.
Yeah.
So that time I saw a lot of things happening, and I was with Ireland, just got my sign up with Ireland and all them things, and pressure coming on to me and doing rehearsals day and night. I'm in studio, going on tour, and this and that. And I couldn't take it. My mind was going, man.
Mm.
So I said, you know, I got to run off, you know. So I run to the A's from when it's coming, my help, you know.
Yeah.
My help coming from Jah. Was made yeah, of Zen and Earth, you know?
Well, that's what we say, it's all about balance.
Balance.
So so on that note, is there anything you'd just like to wrap things up before we get out of here today? We only got 8 minutes.
I want to take it first, go, brother Mike.
Yeah, I just want to big up the Rastafarian community Celestia. In Melbourne.
Mm-hmm.
You know, want to big up brother Simon, Empress Kyla for bringing us here. Bring up all the PBS Massive, you know, for having playing our music on the it's radio.
Everything.
You know, yeah, man, I want to big up all the Jamaican, Caribbean people that are here in Melbourne, and all the Australian brothers and sisters out there who are coming out tonight. Just come out in your tens and thousands, come hear the words of righteousness, the words of Rastafari, you know? Because Rastafari is life, and life is forevermore.
Bless her.
Give thanks.
Well, the messenger reaching out to all my fans out there in Radio Land, Melbourne, and all over Australia. I just want to tell you that the messenger is yours truly, and I will always be singing positive music. Keep the faith, my people. Right now we're going through troubled times, spiritual upheavals and all these things, war and crime and violence in every part of the earth. We need to create a balance right now, and this is what we're doing with the music. Come on out later, we shall have a grand time. Blessed love.
Yes.
Give thanks again for all my fans in the house.
Well, I've got to give thanks to the both of you for coming here today, for making the journey all the way to Australia, but for coming into PBS and fantastic show. You know,
pleasure
truly
honored. Thank you very much, man. Blessed love. Rastafari.
Right now, we've got to give away a double pass to the first PBS caller, the first PBS member to ring through on 84151067. We've got a double pass to the show tonight. I'm going to play a tune right now. This one on the Storm label, thing called Hot Stepper. You're on PBS.
Living in a dreadful time.
Living in a dreadful time.
Oh, man. Man. Oh, the meditation.
I say I ain't gonna take it from top and break the lounge off this one. Out.
Comes around. Hot
before you take a life consider. Youth man, go put on your tool. Oh, Shatta, before you press another gun trigger, remember your mama and papa. Abide by your father's rule.
Luciano and Mikey General there, bringing some real vibes to the studios of PBS back in January 2007. That's it for another one. Thanks as always to Patreon patrons the Don Armagedian Time, the Real General Empress Irie, Tom Tanaki, and DJ Pablito. If you'd like to support the podcast, please become a patron or just help spread the word. Leave a 5-star review on whatever podcast platform you use. Thanks for listening. Eyes is every time.
37 chambers of the Bingi Temple. Rastaman sit up in a no time for idle. Swinging in a me hammock while the whole world a tremble. Sing this little song to the chant down people. Up in the hills where the rivers run cool. Bullets and jungle swimming down in my pool. Staying away from the land of the fool. Jesse Ivy, they are cool.
Yeah, you don't know. I told the right to swear, Mikey General and Luciana.
Yeah, man, I told the mighty way, man. And look at someone get chant down in the middle of the dance hall.
Now
anyway,
easy, Jesse
down.
I. Slash Rascal, Domita.
Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry I own love. Chant down, sweet champion sound, Lord. Some boy pack you back and go back home.
All right. God bless we all, the pain I come.
A lie, lie, lie. They might tell Pongwe. Oh, oh, oh. Well, they might talk about Jesse. I know love is majesty. A lie, yes, a lie, lie, lie. They might tell Pongwe. Oh, 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 oh. When they might talk about chant down, no love is majesty. Oh, no, you know, don't let
Jesse, I can face the world because I know that righteousness rules the earth.
Wanna live, Jah bless me all.
Selassie, I know.